Welcome to another episode of Sailing Ruby Rose. It is the 8th of August today because I know that some of you are desperate to know exactly how close to real time these episodes are filmed. Obviously our patrons get them a week earlier, so if you're interested in Patreon, up there. Anyway, 8th of August, what can I show you? That is hull one, not Ruby Rose two, that's hull number two. You will notice today that the coach roof has been lifted off, and there is a very, very good reason for that. This is the first boat that's in production. So what they did, if you remember back to our previous episode, they had the main bulkhead, and that main bulkhead, the one that is actually holds a trifold door, is a very, very complicated piece of kit. If you remember the interview that I did with Richard Ward, pre-COVID now, he talked about how much engineering had to go into the trifold door area, reinforce the bulkhead to have such a big opening. And they worked very closely with a New Zealand company, I believe, to try and make sure that the bulkhead would take such a large opening span. And so it is one of the most important parts in this boat. So just to kind of run through the evolution of this, number one, obviously it was done with the computer aided design. They kind of knew the tolerances on the computer. Then they mocked the whole thing up in their green MDF that they use for all the mock-ups. Next thing, they make the whole bulk actually in fiberglass as a kind of mock-up bulkhead and dry fit that. And then they do all the adjustments to that, and then they use the dry fit to make and infuse the final bulkhead, and that today is being put in. Super, super interesting to see like the evolution of this bulkhead, because it is such, as I said, an important part. And you can see just behind me there, that is the old bulkhead, or the try-in bulkhead. With all the adjustments made, they pulled it out, that'll get discarded. So today what we've got to show you, the trifold door area, that big bulkhead that's going in, the furniture cabinetry, the rudders over there. This guy over here is super, super interesting. His English is probably about as good as my Vietnamese is, so we kind of like mix the languages, but yeah. He's doing a lot of work on that. And yeah, there's lots to see. There are little things going on, little things, everything moving slowly forward. There are now six hulls there. One is moving on really, really quickly. The deck for two will be next week. Honestly, at this point, I'm super pumped about it all, but let us walk through and show you exactly what I mean by all this, the trifold door, the bulkhead, and everything else going on with that. So again, once this bulkhead is in place and they can then move to actually put the carbon coach roof and actually fuse that. So once they've got deck already fused on hull one, bulkhead, but then we need to go and look at the targa arch. That targa arch all in carbon fiber is going to be like a huge engineering project. And I will go to the other factory to have a look at that as well. So honestly, the support mechanism for the hard top, that's the windows, the targa arch and the bulkhead, once those are all bonded in, they will then put the hard top back on, and then you do have a completed boat. So super, super interesting. Let's go on board and take a really good look at everything there. Hope you enjoy this one. Long introduction, but hey, I can talk a glass eye to sleep. And so here we are, hull number one. You can see that here the crane kind of like tensioning up as they lift that bulkhead out. So basically the bulkhead is being dry fitted in and out, as you saw with the whole deck fitting. And what they're doing is literally just adjusting very, very slightly any rubbing points. Rubbing points obviously cause squeaks, cause abrasion, and cause damage to the bond between the two parts. They've spent all morning dry fixing this, and when it's right, that will all be bonded in place. But they will then take the measurement and take them to subsequent holes. Talking to James this morning, super interesting. He was saying that essentially between every different boat, for the first six boats, they will halve, or they envisage halving the amount of time for each procedure. So, but arbitrarily, if it takes 10 hours to do this fix, it will take five for hole number two, and then 2.5, and then 1.25 hours, because the team get faster and faster and faster. And they've got empirical evidence for this. What they were saying is that when they came to do the adjustments to dry fit deck two for us, that literally took half the time that it did for deck one. And so this is how there will be almost an exponential decrease in the amount of time required between hole one and say hole six, when they will get their production up. The other thing is that now you can see where this is all going into place. Once this is bonded in and the targa arch is bonded in, you can then start working on things like steering and all the mechanisms that go into that area, to the mechanics of it, the guts of the boat. So these guys, it is almost 9:45 in 15 15 minutes, these guys will go on their break and I will go on board to film so that I do not disturb their workflow or detract from Seawind's scheduling. So give me 15 minutes, we'll be back on board to see exactly what they're doing. There you go, looks nice. Looks nice. There we go, so we've got a bulkhead in place now. And so here we are. Let's just take a walk. Something I want to show you. Look at this. Look at the size of this. Huge, no? Huge. Look at the beautiful white gel coat. Look at it. Beautiful. White. Glowing like my teeth. No, I'm not seeing too much coffee. But, and this is the important thing. As I walk through here, something you're all going to want to see. As I spin around, black. 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 Whole thing's carbon fiber. Amazing. Carbon fiber coach roof. Carbon fiber bulkhead. Carbon fiber bulkhead. I want you to just think how much carbon fiber you have all watched go into this boat. When you see these huge pieces, these huge structural pieces being built in carbon fiber, the weight saving from this is going to be staggering. So let's have a little look around, just on the inside of this. And really at this point, all I can say to you is that there is so much work going into the weight saving on this. I know that Utrecht's gunboats, they all use a lot of carbon fiber, but this essentially is a semi-production catamaran. And to be able to see things like this, yeah, that fills me with a lot of faith. Other things that we've talked about, and I'm not going to mention, I'm not going to talk about other companies. We talk about tolerances, and this isn't my tolerance or intolerance of idiots, but I want you to talk about tolerances between different parts that fit together. And especially my hard-on for different things is badly fitting bulkheads. Can you have a hard-on for badly fitting bulkheads? Probably. So let's just look at tolerances. This is dry fitted, and I'm just gonna spin the camera around, and I want you to all take a very, very good look at what we're looking at for tolerances and squeaks. So there, as I look there, oh, we're looking probably an eighth of an inch down there. Down there, nothing. It's actually completely snug. And it is these little things that when I look at a boat and when I look at the build and when I'm just looking, running my fingers along these areas, you need to think how much work has gone in to building a piece of carbon fiber. Must be 5-6 meters across, where the tolerances and the fit is this good. Engineering at its finest. That is a beautiful, beautiful piece of kit. While we are here, let's just take a spin through the rest of this hull. I just want to take a whiz through into here. Not a lot has gone on here, but there are things that we can see that have progressed. The bulkhead for the walk-in wardrobe is now done. And I talked about this green MDF before, how they pad all this out just to kind of get the shapes before actually going to final fit. So there's obviously these bulkheads. This goes on to the carbon bulkhead, but we're actually starting to look like a boat now. And you can also see in hull one exactly the type of engine access you're going to be able to get from here. Okay, down into the guest hull. So yeah, a lot blocked out here, but also things like here where we've got the holding tank. Lots and lots and lots to see. Super happy with everything going on.
One other thing to note today is that the cross beams are being assembled, and these will form an integral part of the catamaran, the Seawind 1370. Let's just take a walk through this. We have obviously an extruded aluminium beam which goes transversely across the bows of the boat. Now at each end there are milled aluminium parts which are then welded and tapped and drilled to both ends. Again, if you are a nerd and into this sort of detail, these are very, very, very sturdy and well built, and it's nice to see a level of craftsmanship like this. I also have a real thing for the quality of the welding here. So as we move down, we can see that there's tapped and then drilled bolts that go through to hold the milled parts into place. And then as we move forward, we can see that we've got a lot of amazing, amazing welding. Sorry to kind of like emphasize this too much, but like when you see welding like this, I've seen some really bad welding. This is super good stuff. But again, it's really lovely to see. And this will all be kind of like bolted into place on the bows of the 1370. Lovely thing to see, and really from our point of view it shows another aspect of the boat that is really coming together. These structural components will obviously be vital for the sailing performance of Ruby Rose 2. Lovely to see. And then just go to the other end, we've got another milled aluminium component there. This is exactly where we're going to fit the crossbeam, so it goes through the bowsprit, and then again structural rigidity from this. one other thing that was available for us to see was the rudders on the 1370s. So these are the two rudders, and there's one of the guys here, he's a really lovely chap, just making sure that everything is perfect and fairing it down to make sure that rudder number one has absolutely no imperfections in it, so that when it is used to make rudders 2, 3, and 4, we have absolutely perfectly smooth without any dimples.
Anyway, I hope you enjoyed that episode. Lovely to see hole one coming on so well. This is an amazing piece of kit, and next time I'm going to go and have a look to see how they're getting on with that targa arch, because with a carbon fiber targa arch and this beautiful piece of kit in place, there is going to be a whole heap of progress on the C-130-70. So listen, I really hope you enjoyed that. This, between my life in Vietnam and watching boat building, there are so many things to show you. There's a lot of other things coming up in the subsequent episodes of just my life in Vietnam that I hope you find interesting. I know some of you don't really want to all see boat building. Touring Vietnam, doing work for outreach for children, a lot of things I want to talk to you about, just to kind of show you like the richness of life here. So hope you enjoyed that. Give us a like, give us a thumbs up. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, probably something down there that you probably can click. I will see you all next week with another episode. Stay safe wherever you are. I will see you all soon. Goodbye.